welcome to this session. As the theme of this session goes, building a sustainable education business. So there are two important words in this particular title. It's sustainable and it's business. And the foundation is education. So this title is somewhat an oxymoron if you are talking of education in Indian perspective and we are talking of business. I think they don't gel well together. As we know that as far as our Indian context is concerned, education is normally considered as a not-for-profit venture. But since we know that whatever is not non-profitable, it is not at all sustainable. So there has to be some sustainable surplus, which is indirectly the profit element, or you can say the management of those education things. So we have this particular title which goes building a sustainable education business. Now the point of concern is that this is the right time that we need to understand and deliberate on this particular session, because we know that considering our current demographics, where we are talking of demographic dividend, wherein our youth population is the largest one as well as the world is concerned, and particularly the emphasis with lot of pre-K students and lot of school kids who are going to venture in job space maybe once their schooling is over. But the point is that right now whatever education system exists in our country in terms of curriculum, in terms of training and development, in terms of learning outcomes, they are very, very less, or I will say only 5 to 10% linked with the industrial outcome. Because we know that when the child is out of the school, as far as the employability or livelihood linkages are concerned, they are very, very less. And considering that most of the students come from rural background, wherein we need to train these students, we need to put these students immediately in job. And as we know that in most of these rural areas, or particularly in tier 2 and tier 3 cities, where there's more proliferation of micro, small and medium enterprises, they don't have the resources and wherewithal to train students, to spend money, to spend time on those students. Therefore, if we are able to nurture our students right from school level, as far as skilling is concerned, I think that will be one of the game changers in order to generate employment, and also in order to have the target of government, which is skilling as well as training 500 million youth by year 2022.